पूरी श्री राज रामचंद्र की जय। बिफोर आई प्रेजेंट द मैसेज वी हैव अ भजन बाय पंडित उमेश। एज वी फोकस अपॉन द डिवाइन, विजुअलाइज द डिवाइन इन द माइंड आई एज वी प्रेज हिम।
हे देवी रमजूती है, सर्वस्वरूपे तुझको बारंबार प्रणाम। हे देवी तू रमजूती है, सर्वस्वरूपे तुझको बारंबार प्रणाम। तुझको बारंबार प्रणाम। सर्वगुणमयी विश्वमोहिनी कांत स्वरूपे कांत स्वरूपे तुझको बारंबार प्रणाम। तुझको बारंबार प्रणाम। तू ही साधन में तू माया है, जग जीवन में तू ही है आशा कृष्णा में। भ्रांति स्वरूपे भ्रांति स्वरूपे तुझको बारंबार को बारंबार प्रणाम। निज भक्तों का पालन करती पापों बोझ पृथ्वी का हर, दुष्ट असुर संकारे रण में शांति स्वरूपे शांति स्वरूपे तुझको बारंबार प्रणाम। तुझको गाते गुण सब ऋषि मुनि नारद। तू ही काली लक्ष्मी शारदा गाते गुण सब ऋषि मुनि नारद। लक्ष्मण का धार तू ही है विश्व स्वरूपे विश्व स्वरूपे तुझको बारंबार प्रणाम। तुझको बारंबार प्रणाम। हे देवी तू रमज्योति है, सर्व स्वरूपे तुझको बारंबार प्रणाम। तुझको बारंबार प्रणाम। तुझको बारंबार प्रणाम।
बोली श्री आदिशक्ति जगदम्बा माता की जय. Now devotees, each person is said to be fourfold in nature. Man is a physical being, a social being, a mental being, as well as a spiritual being. Now these four aspects of man can be compared to the four corners of a square. If a square is twisted, all we need to do is to rectify one angle, and all the other angles would automatically fall into place. In life, when things go out of balance, out of equilibrium, as we say, we need to rectify the different angles: physical, social, mental, spiritual. But it is a conviction of the sages that if I rectify the spiritual angle, automatically all the other angles fall into place, as in the square. Because of the properties of a square, if a square is skewed, all we need to do is rectify one angle. If we observe in life, whenever problems arise, difficulties, challenges, we are advised, turn to God. Turn to God. But therein lies another question. Have we turned away from Him so that we should now turn to Him? And if one analyzes, one would come to the conclusion, quite often we tend to forget that divine. When problems, difficulties, challenges come, we tend to remember the divine. If He is the solution to all of life's problems, the answer to all of life's questions, why then do we turn away from Him? The sages tell us, before we are born, we made a promise to that divine. O Lord, there are 8,400,000 species of creation. Grant me the human form, Manush Sharir. Why? Because a human being possesses the mind, man. From man you get Manushya. I have the free will. I am not subjected to instinct as animals do. So bless me with this human form, with that inner equipment. I will worship you. I will seek you. I will glorify you. And so, that Lord is infinite mercy, compassion, grants us that form in that we are conceived within mother's womb. We are well protected for about 9 months or thereabout. And after great pain, great expectations, great joy, we are brought forth into this world as a new entity. Tulsi Das Ji, that great poet and sage, looking at man's situation, he has come upon a certain philosophy, a certain realization. We promised yes, but do we fulfill this promise? Promise is a debt. Tulsi Das, in his own literary brilliance, he admonishes us, he reminds us as to the promise we made, the mistakes we make, and if we do not fulfill our promise, the regrets that will ensue. Tulsi Das said very beautifully.
O bhajan bina tihinu pan bigari, bhajan bina tihinu pan bigari, bhajan bina tihinu pan bigari, भजन बिनती रूपन बिगड़ी. खात खेलत बालापन बीते, बोलत है तुतरी खात खेलत बालापन बीते, बोलत है तुतरी आंगन धूरे लपेटत खेलत आंगन धूरे लपेटत मात पिता दुलही हे मात पिता दुलही भजन विनती रूप न बिगड़ी भजन विनती रूप न बिगड़ी भजन विनती.
And so, beginning a new life, subjected to the six modifications, the journey begins. The six modifications of the human being: birth, existence, growth, maturity, decay, death. The journey begins. The first stage in life, the childhood stage, where we are showered with affection, love, protection, rightly so. Our entire life at this point in time is spent in this way, where the playthings of our parents and others, we are their joy. And you can all see from your own experience when your baby is born, how much you love you show upon that child, you know, the protection, everything else. Tulsi Das is saying that in this state of playfulness, in this state of joy, love, wonderful bonding, dular as we call it, one stage passes by and you have not yet begun to fulfill your promise. What does he promise? O Lord, give me a human form. I shall worship you. I shall relentlessly pursue you. Meaning that you shall develop your spirituality. Tulsi is saying, the first stage passes by. You have not yet fulfilled your promise. Bhajan bin tinu pan bigari, he said, without that bhajan, the three stages in life pass by without you knowing it. Much to your regret. One is already gone. The second stage is coming. What is it?
O bhajan binati nupan bigari, bhajan binati nupan bigari, bhajan binati. Jal ma jo shayu bhakan ayo ब्याहलई सुंदरी जाल में जोश युवा बनायो ब्याहलई सुंदरी निशदिन हरि पद छोर भी मूरख निशदिन हरि पद छोर भी मूरख पियत विषय गगरी आ पियत विषय गगरी भजन विनती नूपन बिगड़ी भजन विनती नूपन बिगड़ी भजन विनती नूपन.
And now the second stage approaches, the troublesome stage, the youthful stage, when all the hormones begin to act up. We have no control over the senses, the mind. So we are caught up in the rat race of life. We study, we want to acquire our qualifications, and many couldn't care less about that either. They just want to enjoy pleasures of the sense, much to their detriment. But there are those who pursue their various material goals, objectives in life. Acquire their qualifications, a good job, a home, and now settle down in life, meaning to get a life companion. Young men look for a dulahin. Of course, young women look for a dulaha. And notice what they're looking for. Yeah. So they settle down in life, and all that matters here is that you are successful in acquiring material objectives. Your focus is upon material pursuits. Even when you pray, it is to ask for material things. It is not to seek God for His sake. It is the gimme gimme syndrome, as I keep saying. You have your needs satisfied, but we keep pursuing our greeds. We want to have our greed satisfied also. And so in this stage of life, we are so caught up. The poisons of materialism begin to strangle us. Even when we sit in places of temples, churches, mosques, wherever we go, you think the mind is on God all the time? This is why when I started, I said, when trouble takes us, we think of God. When we are comfortable, we don't think of God. And if we think of Him, it is simply because we want some more material success. And the sages are telling us, you know, all these material successes you have, yes, nothing is wrong, but when you are caught up with these things, when the time comes to depart the mortal coil, do you carry any of these things with you? The sages tell us, Sancho tero naam ram, Sancho tero naam, Jyoti sabka kaam ram, Sancho tero naam, Khali ke aaye the jag mein, Khali ke tum jaavonge, Moti ban ki aaye the, haath pasare jaavonge, Jhootha hai yah gaam ram. At the expense of God, which the sages tell us to relentlessly pursue, we are caught up in material things. The sages remind us, when you come into this world, you come with nothing, not even clothes. When you go with clothes, most people. But you know what? When you're born into this world, you come with the fists tied, so to speak. But then when time to leave, what happens? You go with the palms open to show the world, look, I carry nothing with me. I carry nothing with me. I leave everything behind. Tulsi is paying some attention to this. So caught up are we, drinking from the pitcher of materialism, the poisons of materialism, we do not really focus upon the divine. The second stage passes by. We have not yet repaid our debt of gratitude. We have not yet fulfilled our word to the Lord. We are still in bondage. Time passes on. Time doesn't stop. Time doesn't stand still. And so, the final stage in life approaches. If the second stage comes with all its attendant distractions, the next stage comes with all its attendant ills. What is the next stage? Tulsi is saying,
O bhajan binati nupana bigami, bhajan binati nupana bigami, bhajan bina vritha bhayi yanga thakan lage kap pit vayu hire vritha bhayi anga thakan lage कपित वायु गिरे तुलसीदास पचितात से जबर तुलसीदास पचितात से जबर तुलसीदास पचितात से जबर अब हम क्या रे करे ओ अब हम क्या रे करे ए अब हम क्या रे करे भजन बिन की भूवन भजन बिन तीनों पन बिगरी बिगरी हाँ तीनों पन बिगरी तीनों पन बिगरी बिगरी हो तीनों पन बिगरी तीनों पन बिगड़ी बिगड़ी तीनों पन बिगड़ी बिगड़ी तीनों पन बिगड़ी ओ तीनों पन बिगड़ी भजन बिन तीनों पन बिगड़ी भजन बिन तीनों पन बिगड़ी भजन बिन
Old age, devotees, old age now creeps in. That is, if we live to get old. In today's world, mortality amongst the young is quite high for various reasons. The base reason is karma, of course. But Tulsi is saying, we live to get old, the final stage in life comes by. Now, the humors of the body, kapha, pitta, and vata, they begin to act up. There is imbalance. All of us have within us these three humors, as we call them, kapha, pitta, and vata. You know, bile, phlegm, and wind. And imbalances take place so that health is poor. We have different problems. The senses become debilitated. Now, you know what? I have plenty of time. When I say I have retired, I have nothing to do, plenty of time on my hands, but I don't have the energy. Now, Tulsi is saying when you reach to this kind of stage, you can't hear properly, you can't see properly. To sit down is a problem. You could pray to God then? Can you perform sacrifices then? As many would say, at that stage, call you Baba, let me do a puja. When Baba say, huh, you here now. How could you concentrate? How could you just go through blind rituals? Tulsi is saying, when you reach to this stage, what will be in the heart? Ab hum kya rikari? What can we do at this point in time? There's only regret. Regret. God, I wish I had more time. I wish I could have done so. I wish I did so. If wishes were horses, beggars might ride. The key to success in life is to strike that balance throughout. Yes, the physical is necessary, the mental, social, not at the expense of the spiritual. Not at the expense of the spiritual. Do you know why? Because man by nature is divine. And if I do not tap into my divinity, I'm out of sync with myself. I have mentioned also that the scriptures have given to us various upais. You see, there is a bond between matter and spirit. That imaginary ligature we call Maya, which is imaginary. And we have to untie that imaginary ligature. Scriptures have given to us various practices. But rather than free ourselves, we become more bound and tied down. You know why? Because we use the pujas, we use the yagyas, we use the jap, we use the tap, we use all these sacrifices given to us to free ourselves, to bind us further by asking and begging for material things, which bind us to this world. Devotees, what is for you will always come to you. Nobody could take it away. And what is not for you, you can't get it. We spoke of fate, destiny. What is your destiny will always take effect. Therefore, why worry about that? Why not think of God? Seek Him. Sarva dharman paritajya mame kam sharam vaja. Bhagavan Sri Krishna Gita says, resign all duties to me. Relentlessly pursue me. Yoga chemam vahamyaham. I shall personally take responsibility for all your needs. The key to the whole thing is that no matter what, always be God conscious. Let these wonderful qualities of spirituality dominate the mind. Let there be no weaknesses. Love, the key. Love. So what I'm projecting to you, in society today, there is so much scheme, so much hatred, so much animosity. Nobody seeks God in the sense that they want Him for His sake. Everything becomes a show. Everything becomes a tamasha, as we say. We can't fool God. Again, I remind you, koi la kare chaturai, karma ka lekha mite nare bhai. Nobody could above your karmas. Therefore, it's wise to be wise. Wake up. Don't fool yourselves. We must not fool ourselves. God knows what takes place in the deepest recesses of the mind. We can't fool Him. We have made a promise to Him. We seek Him for His sake. And there is one compelling reason why, as I've been emphasizing. Aham Brahmasmi. I am one with divinity. This is my nature. The empirical human being is not the human being. It's not the right person. It's not me. The me is Atma, which is part and parcel of Paramatma. Chidananda Rupaha, Shivoham Shivoham. I must relentlessly pursue that divine. If I fail to do so, there will be regrets and nothing else but regrets. So, we seek that divine.
भजु घन श्याम भजु मुरली गोपाल भजु नंद के लाल भजो हे राधे नंद के लाल भजो गिरिधर गोपाल मथुरा नाथा कमल नयन हे केवल यदमा भजु घन श्याम भजु मुरली गोपाल भजु भजु घन श्याम भजु मुरली गोपाल भजु
भजु घन श्याम भजु मुरली गोपाल भजु
नंद के लाल भजो
राधे नंद के लाल भजो
हे राधे नंद के लाल भजो
राधे
गिरिधर गोपाल मथुरानाथ
गिरिधर गोपाल मथुरानाथ
गिरिधर गोपाल गिरिधर गोपाल मथुरानाथ
गिरिधर गोपाल मथुरानाथ
कमल नयन कमल नयन हे केवल्यदामा
कमल नयन हे केवल्यदामा
भजु घन श्याम भजु मुरली गोपाल भजु
भजु घन श्याम भजु मुरली गोपाल भजु
नंद के लाल भजु
राधे नंद के लाल भजु
हाँ राधे नंद के लाल भजो
राधे नंद के लाल भजो
गिरिधर गोपाल मथुरानाथ
गिरिधर गोपाल मथुरानाथ
गिरिधर गोपाल गिरिधर गोपाल मथुरानाथ
गिरिधर गोपाल मथुरानाथ
हे मथुरानाथ
मथुरानाथ
हे मथुरानाथ
मथुरानाथ
हे गिरिधर गोपाल गिरिधर गोपाल गिरिधर गोपाल मथुरानाथ
गिरिधर गोपाल मथुरानाथ
कमल नयन हे केवल यदमा
कमल नयन हे केवल
हे कमल नयन हे
श्याम
भजु मुरली गोपाल भजु
भजु घन श्याम